It's the biggest Rome Certified pre-owned sales event of the year going on now at Camelot. For a limited time, you'll save up to 50% MSRP on your choice of all year-end model closeouts.
Reason with me, my small desert children. Are you not sick and tired of always having to pull over during a sandstorm? Here at Camelot, even our base models are equipped with long eyelashes and sealable nostrils. Still not convinced? Try our Performance Track 2-Tone Soul Advanced model with all-toe drive to get you through even the most treacherous terrain on the dunes. Hurry in to take advantage of these super low prices for tall camels. With prices this low, our inventory won't last long. As long as it takes for a camel spit to hit the ground is as much time as you have in to get your deal today. Good credit? Bad credit? No credit? Aladdin's lamp? Doubloons buried in the backyard? It's no problem at all. Don't sweat it. We've got a camel priced right for you. Whether you're looking to trade in or expand your caravan, we've got you covered.
Plus financing options, just 19.99% for only 72 months. Keep your payments affordable. Our expert team inspects every camel from tooth to hump to toe before it qualifies for pre-certified status. Some limitations apply. Call now for a free estimate.
Buy smart, buy with confidence. Buy with us at Camelot.
Taxes, fees, and hidden costs not included. Call now.
My job requires me to stay in top form if I want to be the best messenger for the Cursus Publicus. That's why I rely on Honey Locust Crunch to fuel my day and keep me going long after the other messengers have called it quits. Honey Locust Crunch. Breakfast cereal is made of sweet golden honey from real local farms and fortified with real organic dried locusts to give it a crunch that really satisfies. Honey Locust Crunch. Breakfast of messengers.
Experts say the less than popular new census decree and certain tax increase has spawned a new trend in value and saving money. I guess that would officially make Holy Day Inn the best five-star hotel in the Roman Empire. With clean rooms, towels so fresh you'll want to keep them, free breakfast and valet camel parking, why would you stay anywhere else? You'll find all our inns are conveniently located near the census stations and the local tax office. All this at a price lower than our competitors to keep you ahead of the curve. Being smart with your money has never been easier. Holy Day Inn. We'll leave the candles burning for you.
Willie Hayes here. Are you sick of getting meteor dust and bug guts on your bright white angel wings as soon as you leave heaven to deliver a message for the Lord? Are you tired of scrubbing and brushing your wings only to get them dingy white, like what happens with our competitors' products? Then you need OxyWing with its powerful cleaning agents. Simply spray on OxyWing and watch the grime just disappear. Meteor dust and even bug guts are no match for the cleansing power of OxyWing. OxyWing, get the bug brains out.
Greetings, this is Serafina with H&N's breaking news. Heaven's Got Talent just awarded a golden buzzer. Footage shows a young angel at tonight's audition. receiving the golden buzzer from Judge 3. Announces new products in the development for Flight Angel technology. That's your latest breaking news. Stay tuned for more development in our big event news coverage. This is Safrina of HNN. Greetings, Safrina with an HNN breaking news. ID RL to test its new products for Angel Interdimension travel. We've asked our field reporter, Asaf, to bring us the latest in this exciting news. Asaf, thank you for joining us.
Yes, Serafina. We're here in Quadrant 4, just outside of the renowned IDRL laboratory where Dr. Enoch will test his latest invention in cloaking devices.
Dr. Enoch, thank you for inviting us to this exciting test launch. I have followed your work for centuries since your groundbreaking work was the 2GOD network, the first interdimensional communication network. And we're all thrilled about the latest 4GOD network. Your work is fabulous.
It is my pleasure.
Dr. Enoch, can you explain in plain language what exactly is cloaking technology?
Yes, come closer. Come closer to me, please. Okay, shh. We describe our current technology, cloaking technology, as dynamic camouflage. Dynamouflage, if you will, my child. It allows the test subject you see before you to blend completely into the background, to fade away, as it were. All of your problems, all of your dreams will come true. Thanks to the special coating in the fibers, a technology I developed myself. Now, this new cloak, understand, is made of dynamouflage technology called plasma stealth. Does that sound cool? Because why? It absorbs the bandwidths and renders electromagnetic particles free of charge. Through you, in you, above you, below you. It's Trinitarian. This new plasma stealth you see is enhanced, a cloak that is ready for all angels and subjects to try. Here, would you like to put it on? Say yes.
Yes.
Stand still and face the front of the laboratory. Van Arn. Two arm, beautiful, over the wings. Here, stop, don't touch, you'll mess it up. Here we go, everywhere, all around the ASAF, perfect, you're glorious. Okay, one question left for you. Are you ready? I get out the laboratorial remote control, and on three, I'm fine.
Angel hair and heat.
This is Serafina for H&N. Stay tuned.
Good to be home.
Mm-hmm.
Everything okay?
Fine, just fine.
The roses died, Daddy.
Oh, how come?
Heat from the fire in the garage.
How'd that happen?
Sparks from the house, I suppose.
The house?
Well, the explosion in the basement started it.
I think it was the burglar.
What burglar?
Oh, the policeman caught him.
The policeman tripped over my skate.
Oh, but he's gonna be fine, just fine.
Hey, isn't that our street?
Well, it used to be.
We live in a hotel now, Dad.
Oh, don't worry, dear. Our Allstate homeowners insurance is even going to pay the hotel bill while the house is getting fixed.
Allstate Deluxe homeowners insurance protects against more hazards than you can count. For less money than most companies charge, you're in good hands with Allstate.
New High Karate. The brisk splash-on aftershave that smooths and soothes and cools. Be careful how you use it.
Hi. Wow, what's the aftershave you're wearing?
High Karate. It is so powerful, it drives women right out of their minds. High Karate Aftershave is so powerful, it drives women right out of their minds. That's why we have to put instructions on self-defense in every package. High Karate Aftershave. Be careful how you use it.
Your coffee, ma'am.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Such a handsome husband make horrible coffee.
I heard that.
Frank, what are you doing here?
Oh, Mrs. Olson, Judy craps about my coffee again.
Come on, man. Good coffee is no problem if you use a coffee with better flavor.
Folgers coffee?
Yeah, Folgers is different. They blend in special, and Folgers is mountain-grown coffee.
Mountain-grown?
Yeah, let's smell it. Oh, that will make good coffee.
Thank you. I'll try some.
Coffee, ma'am.
Thank you. Hey! How can such a handsome husband make such good coffee?
I heard that. It's Folgers.
Say it's your birthday. Happy birthday, Jesus. They say it's your birthday. We're gonna have a good time. I'm glad it's your birthday. Happy birthday to you. Yeah, we're going to a party. Yes, we're going to a Christmas party. Yeah, we're going to a party. Happy birthday, Jesus!
Welcome to the Christchurch Santa Fe Christmas Movie Matinee Extravaganza, brought to you by EpoxyNet.
It's the spray that stays for days.
Loving you. You are my heart's treasure, but I lost you. Now I'm coming back for you. I am like the sun gently shining on you, chasing away darkness and fear and death. You'll be so happy. You'll be like little calves running free in an open field, and I am going to send my messenger, the promised one, the one you have been waiting for, the rescuer. He is coming, so get ready. It had taken centuries for God's people to be ready, but now the time had almost come for the best part of God's plan. God himself was going to come, not to punish his people, but to rescue them. God was getting ready to wipe away every tear from every eye, and the true party was just about to begin.
Everything was ready. The moment God had been waiting for was here at last. God was coming to help his people, just as he promised in the beginning. But how would he come? What would he be like? What would he do? Mountains would have bowed down, seas would have roared, trees would have clapped their hands, but the earth held its breath. As silent as snow falling, he came in, and when no one was looking, in the darkness, he came.
There was a young girl who was engaged to a man named Joseph. Joseph was the great, 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 great grandson of King David. One morning, this girl was minding her own business when suddenly a great warrior of light appeared right there in her bedroom. He was Gabriel, and he was an angel, a special messenger from heaven. When she saw the tall, shining man standing there, Mary was frightened. You don't need to be scared, Gabriel said. God is very happy with you. Mary looked around to see if perhaps he was talking to someone else. Mary, Gabriel said, and he laughed with such gladness that Mary's eyes filled with sudden tears. Mary, you're going to have a baby, a little boy. You will call him Jesus. He is God's own son. He's the one. He's the rescuer. The God who flung planets into space and kept them whirling around and around. The God who made the universes with just a word. The one who could do anything at all. Was making himself small and coming down as a baby. Wait! God was sending a baby to rescue the world? But it's too wonderful, Mary said, and felt her heart beating hard. How can it be true? Is anything too wonderful for God? Gabriel asked. So Mary trusted God more than her eyes could see. and she believed. "I am God's servant," she said. "Whatever God says, I will do."
A girl, she had a baby called Jesus.
She was Jesus' mom.
Oh, yeah. We read about that earlier. And you told her she was going to have a baby, and she was going to name him Jesus.
Gabriel came and told her, an angel.
Very good.
An angel came to her and told Mary that she would have a baby named, and she would be, the baby would be the Savior of God, who'd save people from their sins.
Mary heard from Gabriel that she would have a baby and she would name him Jesus. And that would be, and Jesus would be the Savior. She was very surprised.
Yeah.
She thought it was too good to be true, but nothing is too good to be true for God. I think Mary told Joseph, and then Joseph was really surprised.
Yeah.
And then he might have reacted the same way that Mary did. They were both shocked. I think Jonas would answer that question. I don't know.
What happened to Joseph?
I don't know either.
I think an angel came and calmed him down.
Who calmed him down?
I think an angel or the Lord.
What happened to Joseph then?
He went to sleep. The baby hatched.
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ took place. When Mary, his mother, was engaged to Joseph, before they were married, she became pregnant by the Holy Spirit. Joseph, as her husband, was a righteous man. Because he didn't want to humiliate her, he decided to call off their engagement quietly. As he was thinking about this, an angel from the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife, because the child she carries was conceived by the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you will call him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." Now all of this took place so that when the Lord had spoken through the prophet would be fulfilled. "Look, a virgin will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel." Emmanuel means God is with us. When Joseph woke up, he did just as an angel from God commanded.
Now Mary and Joseph had to take a trip to Bethlehem, the town King David was from. But when they reached the little town, they found every room was full. Every bed was taken.
What? Can't you read the sign? It says no vacancy.
They tried to find somewhere to stay.
When they arrived and they asked for somewhere to stay, the innkeeper said, "No, we don't have any room. No, we don't have any room." And then they had to go to a stable.
You guys like to sleep in a stable?
Maybe.
Really? With the cows and the horses? I don't know. You know, they just poop all over the place.
I know. But I like animals.
I think all the rooms were full and they told them to leave.
There was no beds left in the Bethlehem. They only could sleep in a let-down shed. They couldn't stay at any houses, no inns, no hotels, even though they didn't have those back then.
And there, in the stable, amongst the chickens and the donkeys and the cows, in the quiet of the night, God gave the world his wonderful gift. The baby that would change the world was born. His baby son, Mary and Joseph, wrapped him up to keep him warm. They made a soft bed of straw and used the animal's feeding trough as his cradle. And they gazed in wonder at God's great gift, wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. Mary and Joseph named him Jesus, Emmanuel, which means God has come to live with us, because of course he had.
He was born in a stable.
And they couldn't find anywhere but like a small manger. So they had Jesus there.
In the manger.
Yeah, did you like that?
Yeah.
Do you like the idea of animals being with a baby?
Yeah.
Usually there are horses, cows, chickens, yeah. Donkeys.
Donkey?
Cow.
Cows, yeah.
Maybe there was a duck?
Hey, donkeys. That same night, in amongst the other stars, suddenly a bright new star appeared. Of all the stars in the dark vaulted heavens, this one shone clearer. It blazed in the night and made the other stars look pale beside it. God put it there when his baby son was born to be like a spotlight shining on him, lighting up the darkness, showing people the way to him. You see, God was like a new daddy. He couldn't keep all the good news to himself. He'd been waiting all these long years for this moment, and now he wanted to tell everyone.
And then an angel appeared and told them there's a king being born in a stable. And then the sky opened up and a bunch more angels came and sang. And they found the stable from finding the star.
The shepherds were in the field and they saw the star, and they followed it to the stable that Jesus was born in. Mm-hmm. A bunch of angels came down and started to sing. But first one came down and said that there's a newborn king. Stable.
What did the shepherds do when they heard this good news?
They followed the star.
They did. They didn't stay there. They left, didn't they? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So he pulled out all the stops. He'd sent an angel to tell Mary the good news. He'd put a special star in the sky to show where his boy was. And now he was going to send a big choir of angels to sing his happy song. He's here. He's come. Go and see him, my little boy. Now, where would you send a splendid choir? To a big concert hall, maybe? Or a palace, perhaps? God sent his to a little hillside outside a little town in the middle of the night. He sent all those angels to sing for a raggedy old bunch of shepherds watching their sheep outside Bethlehem. In those days, remember, people used to laugh at shepherds and say they were smelly and call them other rude names, which I can't possibly mention here. You see, people thought shepherds were nobodies, just scruffy old riffraff. But God must have thought shepherds were very important. Indeed, because they're the ones he chose to tell the good news to first. That night, some shepherds were out in the open fields warming themselves by a campfire, when suddenly the sheep darted. They were frightened by something. The olive trees rustled. What was that? A wing beat?
They turned around, Standing in front of them was a huge warrior of light, blazing into darkness. "Don't be afraid of me," the bright shining man said. "I haven't come to hurt you. I've come to bring you happy news from everywhere, everyone everywhere. Today in David's town in Bethlehem, God's son has been born. You can go and see him. He is sleeping in a manger." Behind the angel, they saw a strange glowing cloud, except it wasn't a cloud. It was angels, troops and troops of angels, armed with light. And they were singing a beautiful song. Then, as quickly as they appeared, the angels left.
The shepherds stamped out their fire, left their sheep, raced down the grassy hill, through the gates of Bethlehem, down the narrow cobble streets, through a courtyard, down some steps, past an inn, round a corner, through a hedge, until at last they reached a tumble-down stable. They caught their breath. And quietly, they tiptoed inside. They knelt on the dirt floor. They had heard about this promised child, and now he was here. Heaven's son, the maker of the stars. A baby sleeping in his mother's arms. The baby would be like the bright star shining in the sky that night. A light to light up the whole world, chasing away darkness. Helping people to see. And the darker the night got, the brighter the star would shine.
My favorite holiday is Christmas because it was the day that Jesus rose and was born.
We're going to go to our aunt's house and we're going to visit a tar pit and we're going to see a rose parade and more things.
So tell me about Christmas. What do you like best about Christmas?
Oh, we get to make the Christmas list before it's Christmas. How many days Christmas?
No.
You got to tell me.
No.
No, after Thanksgiving. And we need to make Christmas lists.
What are you going to put on your list?
A BB-8.
BB-8.
And a singing underwear. And hey. Yeah, well, this is going to be my pen for those stuff.
Okay.
What has been your favorite present for Christmas?
Roller skates.
Ooh.
Because I got roller skates.
Ooh. Do you know how to ice skate?
And for the roller skates, I got knee pads.
Oh, okay.
Because when I used to do roller skates, I used to fall on my knees.
That's awesome. Yeah. What do you want this Christmas? Do you make a list?
Skateboard.
Really?
But I need a helmet with it.
Yes, you do.
And knee pad.
I like spending time with my family.
What's been your favorite thing about Christmas so far in your life?
Well, last year I got a Nintendo Switch. That was fun.
What do you want this year?
I don't know.
You don't know yet? You're gonna have to work on your Christmas list.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas!